Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to get started with Zapier by helping you create your first Zap. All right, so getting right into this, if you've never heard of or used Zapier before, basically it's a tool that's used for automating a lot of different types of tasks. And let's briefly touch on some of the more fundamental terminology. So an automation is called a Zap. Some common examples are sending a notification when someone subscribes to your newsletter, or adding a new row to a Google Sheet anytime a sale is made. It can get very in-depth as you become more familiar with the process. Now, in this video, we're going to use Hubstaff and Zapier to create a simple trigger so you can get familiar with the basics of creating a Zap. And our goal here is to show a notification in Slack anytime someone starts tracking time to a specific project. Slack is obviously another incredibly popular tool, and this trigger we're setting up is a great way to keep your team up to date with what you're working on. Now, I already set up a channel for this Zap on Slack, and I'm gonna put that up on screen so you can see it. It's called New Website Design, and this is going to be a place where I keep information about this specific project in conjunction with my project management tool or whatever else you might be using to track progress. So as you can see here, there are notifications for when I started reviewing the wireframe of the new website design. And this lets others see what you're focused on, so they know not to interrupt with a Slack message. And it can also alert project managers or other teammates that you're working on an important project, so they know they don't have to check in. Moving back over to Zapier, here's how you can set something up just like this. First, we'll select Hubstaff, since that's the app responsible for the initial trigger, and the trigger we're focusing on is timer started. So here I'll connect my Hubstaff account, and if you don't have your account connected yet, you'll be prompted to do so here, or you can always connect your account beforehand by making your way over to the My Apps section. Now then, moving right along, our next step is to choose the organization that my Hubstaff account is a part of, and then we will specify who will be triggering this action, and that would be me. The last step is to test the trigger, and this is where Zapier will make sure everything is connected and firing properly with the account you've connected. And the app we want to select here is Slack. And this is where we're deciding what we want Slack to do in response to our timer starting. So I can choose a few different things here. I could choose send private message if I wanted the notification to go to me or a specific channel. You can see send channel message if I want to have something automatically sent to a specific channel like the one I showed you earlier. And here is where all of the customization for this action happens. You can see this is where we can specify what the message text will be, as well as what channel it will be posted in, and much more. Now I'm gonna speed through some of these sections and just fill out some of the more important information here. And there you go, we're ready to push this Zap live. And remember, there is a lot of different things you can do with Zaps as well. So to give you a few other examples, you could create a new task in Hubstaff when you receive a new email. You can create events in Google Calendar when new shifts are scheduled, add a customer in QuickBooks Online when you create a client in Hubstaff, and much more. And with that, we'll go ahead and wrap up the video here. If you found it helpful, please feel free to hit that thumbs up right down below. Also, if you have any additional questions, you can always leave a comment down below the video and we'll be sure to get back to you. And as always, thank you so much for watching and we'll talk to you soon.